Nang matapos ang hearing, naging mas malinaw na hindi lamang pala iilan ang problema kinakaharap nito. Ni hindi natin alam kung ano pa talaga ang sinusukat ng mga makinaryang ito. Nakakabahala rin na ang mismong listahan ng mga accredited PMBICs ay hindi inilathala sa publiko hanggang nagpatawag ng mga pagdinig ang komite. Nang sinuri ng komite ang mga papeles ng mga authorized PMBICs, lumalabas na kalahate or 12 out of 24 sa mga PMBICs ay walang sapat na capitalization upang makapagpatayo ng isang inspection center na kadalasan ay nagkakahalaga di umano ng 50 million pesos. Of the target 458, only 24 PMBICs are in operation and all of those are for light vehicles and motorcycles and tricycles only. To date, there is no PMBIC servicing heavy-duty vehicles, the ones more prone to mechanical issues that cause large-scale road accidents. Kulang na kulang ang mga PMBIC sa kasalukuyan, kaya hindi nito matutugunan ang demand. There are some machines which are incompatible with the current IT system of LTO. Bakit pinayagan ang mga makina na hindi naman pala kayang magpadala ng resulta sa LTO database? Tandaan po natin na ang liit-liit ng babayaran ng mga private centers na to sa gobyerno, parang 50,000 pesos lang a year. And if I'm not mistaken, Senator Recto mentioned that they will stand to earn between 6 to 8 billion pesos a year. Maaring ibinaba ng pansamantalang inspection fees para sa pribadong sasakyan. Kung biglang hindi na natin ito pinapansin, baka bigla na naman nilang itaas ang kanilang mga singil. Mr. President, ngayon, pag ikaw ay opisyal ng DOTR o empleyado, pwede kang magmay-ari ng private motor vehicle inspection center dahil tinanggal nila doon sa requirement na dapat pag ikaw ay related sa isang official doon, hindi ka pwede sumama. Ngayon, ang hindi lang pwedeng sumama ay yung mga nasa accreditation committee. So kaduda-duda na talaga.
Ilan lamang ito sa matutungayan natin tungkol sa inilabas na committee report number 184 ni Senator Grace Poe sa naganap na plenary session kahapon, ika-24 ng Pebrero. Ito ay meron pa rin kaugnayan sa kontrobersyal na pagpapatupad ng DOTR at LTO sa kanilang bagong programa na Private Motor Vehicle Inspection System. Gusto ko sana na mas paiklin pa itong video pero masyadong malaman ang kanyang mga pahayag tungkol sa usapin na sa tingin ko ay dapat na malaman nating mga motorista. At para malaman natin ang lahat, bumalik tayo sa simula.
Good afternoon, Mr. President and dear colleagues. I put forward the report of the Committee on Public Services, which on February 9, 2021, conducted a hearing on the operation of Private Motor Vehicles Inspection Centers, or PMVIC. Back in 2018, the DOTR decreed that the physical inspection of vehicles, which was previously conducted by the Land Transportation Office, along with an additional battery of tests, 73 in total, shall now be conducted by private motor vehicle inspection centers, which it will accredit outside the usual modes of procurement. As mentioned in the report, the main objective of the committee hearing was to shed light on the issues currently hounding the operation of PMBICs. Nang matapos ang hearing, naging mas malinaw na hindi lamang pala iilan ang problema kinakaharap nito. Kaya ang naging resolusyon ng komite, ang polisiya mismo ang may problema. It is not lost to the committee that the motor vehicle inspection system was probably done with good intentions. That is, towards the goal of ensuring that vehicles in the Philippines are roadworthy. These evils, however, will not be solved simply through privatization that unnecessarily adds burden on the public under suspicious circumstances. The committee found several glaring and serious issues. Allow me to give you a brief rundown. First, as raised during the hearing, the issuances of DOTR lack an official definition of roadworthiness, which, when coupled with a lack of transparency in the inspection standards guarantees that there will be errors in the test results. Ni hindi natin alam kung ano pa talaga ang sinusukat ng mga makinaryang ito. Next, there was also a lack of transparency in the accreditation of PMBICs as evidenced by live streams of the proceedings submitted to the committee where 16 PMBICs were not even mentioned or shown. Nakakabahala rin na ang mismong listahan ng mga accredited PMBICs ay hindi inilathala sa publiko hanggang nagpatawag ng mga pagdinig ang committee. To make matters worse, there was no evidence that consultations were conducted. According to LTO Assistant Secretary Edgar Galvante, he directed his regional directors to conduct the consultation and invite the public. However, it is not clear how many consultations were conducted and what the outcome of these consultations were as the LTO failed to submit the minutes of these consultations despite requests. Hindi malinaw kung pumayag nga ba ang mga motorista na 300% increase ng testing fees. Local executives also lamented that they were not consulted prior to the operations of PMBICs in their area. Hence, the LGUs failed to conduct their inspections first. This is the experience of the city of San Fernando, La Union, and the province of Calapan, Oriental, Mindoro. There was also failure to comply with documentary and legal requirements. Nang sinuri ng komite ang mga papeles ng mga authorized PMBICs, lumalabas na kalahate or 12 out of 24 sa mga PMBICs ay walang sapat na capitalization upang makapagpatayo ng isang inspection center na kadalasan ay nagkakahalaga di umano ng 50 million pesos. Meanwhile, 8 others were registered as sole proprietorships with the DPI which contained no information as to their financial standing. The DOTR failed to submit supporting documents that will show that accredited PMBIC's compliance with the documentary and legal requirements despite our requests. 24 na lang ang PMBICs ngayon. The number of PMBICs currently in operations is grossly insufficient. There is a total of 458 target PMBIC sites, 347 of which are for regular vehicles, while 111 are for heavy-duty vehicles. Of the target 458, only 24 PMBICs are in operation, and all of those are for light vehicles and motorcycles and tricycles only. To date, there is no PMBIC servicing heavy-duty vehicles, the ones more prone to mechanical issues that cause large-scale road accidents. Kulang na kulang ang mga PMBIC sa kasalukuyan, kaya hindi nito matutugunan ang demand. The system created by the hasty rollout of PMBICs is in danger of violating the Equal Protection Clause by mandating an undue requirement on motorists residing in locations where PMBICs is present, while such obligation is absent on those living in sites where a PMBIC is not yet set up. The way the system is being run is also seemingly incompatible with the landscape of motor vehicles in the country. The issuances are not clear if modifications are allowed or only original parts can pass the system. There are also unknown standards depending on brand of equipment. It is thus unfortunate that the DOTR denied knowledge of a list of machines and technical specifications acceptable to its authorizing committee. How did the DOTR evaluate the machines that will inspect the vehicles if they do not even have tech specs? Iba-ibang makinarya, kaya naman iba-iba rin ang nagiging resulta, walang standard. It has unresolved system glitches which cannot be explained absent transparency in the technical specifications of the equipment allowed by the authorization committee. Convincing the public of the value of the new MDIS and encouraging them to trust the results paid for with good money would need more than empty assurances that the system is good. Further, the intent to adopt different minimum standards depending on the type of vehicle being examined is evident from the pronouncement of ASEC Lopez, the head of authorizing committee, who said that they rolled out the PMVICs to the private vehicles first to adjust and possibly reduce the standards to a minimum for PUJs para daw mas maging madali sa mga public utility jeeps. There are some machines which are incompatible with the current IT system of LTO. Bakit pinayagan ang mga makina na hindi naman pala kayang magpadala ng resulta sa LTO database? The excuse that an application programming interface, API, can fix this incompatibility only begs the question, since such a solution will entail substantial extra costs that make incompatible systems expensive. This reeks of either gross oversight or suspicious policy making on the part of the authorization committee. Tandaan po natin na ang liit-liit ng babayaran ng mga private centers na to sa gobyerno, parang 50,000 pesos lang a year. And if I'm not mistaken, Senator Recto mentioned that they will stand to earn between 6 to 8 billion pesos a year. All these issues happened because there was a failure to utilize the MBUC funds for the construction of the government's own inspection centers. If ensuring roadworthiness is really the priority, the government should have made it happen years ago when it had access to the Motor Vehicles Users Charge, MVUC, funds long before the disposition of MVUC collections was amended in 2019. According to LTO's own data submitted to this committee, there's a total of 14.7 billion deposited MVUC collection between 2001 to January 2020, and that should have been earmarked for the Special Vehicle Pollution Control Fund. However, according to DOTR's own data, there's still a total of 11.1 billion unreleased MVUC fund as of June 2019. Whether due to poor planning or failure of bidding, the DOTR missed its chance to utilize the MVUC funds for the construction of public MVICs, which could have shouldered the burden of roadworthiness inspections for the public. Taken together, these issues make it unacceptable for the public to accept a new system which shifted a considerable economic burden on them. It is in view of these issues that this committee recommends the following. Number one, the official repeal of DOTR Department Order 2018-2019, which ordered the privatization of the MVIS and all its related issuances. While the PMVIC seemed to have agreed to lower fees and waive the retesting fees for a year, such commitment must not be left to the discretion or magnanimity of private enterprises. The fees are a creation of the relevant department orders and must be repealed by the same agencies which ordered it. Despite the order of the president, the DOTR and LTO have not yet come up with issuances formalizing the lowered fees and making the MBIC process optional. Maaring ibinaba ng pansamantalang inspection fees para sa pribadong sasakyan. Note, however, that there is no proportionate lowering of rates for inspection of motor vehicles and public utility jeeps. There will be no definite relief as long as the original issuances are not repealed pending resolution of the issues surrounding the system. Kung biglang hindi na natin ito pinapansin, baka bigla na naman nilang itaas ang kanilang mga singil. Second, Congress must be allowed room to determine the propriety of allowing the privatization of MVIS. The implementation of a system so comprehensive as to have far-reaching effects to all motorists in the country is best left to the jurisdiction of the legislature, the same way the Clean Air Act had to make the delegation to private emission testing centers clear and express in the language of the law. Lastly, to recommend to the Senate Blue Ribbon the investigation of the highly anomalous transactions surrounding the accreditation of PMBICs and the officials involved therein. The questionable issuances seem to have created a very favorable environment for oligopoly, where only very few players can enter and succeed. The inexplicable dark moments during the evaluation process and lack of transparency in the eventual accreditation of winning service providers bear badges of fraud, which should be investigated further by the appropriate committee. Mr. President, ngayon, pag ikaw ay opisyal ng DOTR o empleyado, pwede kang magmay-ari ng private motor vehicle inspection center dahil tinanggal nila dun sa requirement na dapat pag ikaw ay related sa isang official doon, hindi ka pwede sumama. Ngayon, ang hindi lang pwedeng sumama ay yung mga nasa accreditation committee. So, kaduda-duda na talaga.
Sa puntong ito ay nagkaroon na ng technical problem at naputol na ang linya ni Senator Grace Poe hanggang sa matapos na siya sa kanyang report. Katulad ng sinabi ko kanina, mahalaga na malaman ito ng lahat ng motorista dahil tayo rin ang papasa ng problemang ito kapag tuluna itong napatupad sa buong bansa. Kaya kung maaari ay share niyo ito sa inyong mga kaibigan para mas marami pang makaalam. Kung meron kayong gustong sabihin tungkol sa napanood niyong video, i-comment nyo lang ito sa ibaba at huwag rin kalimutan na mag-subscribe dito sa Pinoy Car Guy Channel at i-like na rin ang ating Facebook page para palagi kayong updated sa mga bagong kaganapan tungkol sa mga batas at pulisiya na ipinapatupad na merong kaugnayan sa mga sakyan. Uli, ito ang inyong Pinoy Car Guy.